Hey everyone, today I have the lovely Sandra with me, and I wanted to ask her a couple of questions about something which I think might be helpful for us in at the moment, the times that we're living in. So Sandra, you are forever going on about the Daily Examen and how helpful it is to you. Can you just say a bit about what the Daily Examen is?
Yep. Okay. Well, the Daily Examen is a spiritual practice. And what that basically means is that it is something that we do with our body and that we engage in our mind to help us connect closer to God. And basically, it's a form of prayer and it takes us through a few steps so that at the end, we are feeling closer to God.
Cool. So,
yeah.
That sounds good. But when you say Daily Examen, I think of like examination, like a health check, like health examination, medical examination. What is the examen part about?
Well, in a way it is an examination because the point of the examen is to basically go back through your day, like to the beginning of the day, and retrace your steps little by little. And one part of the step in particular is to assess your emotions, to assess your kind of any point in the day where you've gotten upset or angry, and really inviting God into that and asking him why, what was going on there. And so you're really letting God speak into your heart as to what motivations and different things that are going on. So it's an examination, essentially. You're letting God into your heart saying, okay, God, test me.
Sounds like I might have a lot,
a
lot to work through with that. You're always disappearing to go and do a daily examen. Why is it helpful for you?
I do find it really helpful because one of the parts is about gratitude, and I know that I need the constant reminders of the things that God has done during the day, the ordinary things, the mundane things where God was there, and it's constantly becoming aware of God's presence in our lives. So I found that helpful for that respect, but also just for that examination bit, I know that I need that. And it's also helping us gear us towards what's coming next. And so I need just that constant reminder of what has happened, where God was, where I need him, and also where we're going, where God's taking me. So I need it a lot.
What if you're someone, I'm asking for a friend. What if you're someone who doesn't like going through all of your emotions and, or that makes you feel quite anxious? What would you say to my friend?
I would say, don't be afraid, because the person that you're inviting into your heart is God, and he's safe and he's someone that you can trust. And so when you are opening the innards of your life to God, he is gracious and he is so kind. And yes, he will challenge us, but it is always for the betterment. It's so that towards the end, what we're looking at is becoming more like Jesus. And so it's not something to be afraid of.
Cool. I'll text my friend that answer later, or let him watch this video. Cool. Well, maybe we can talk about it, but is there a way you can kind of show us what to do and see if we can try it out?
Sure. I can walk your friend through this kind of practice and stuff. So we can do that together.
Cool. Let's do it. Sign in. Let me get a drink of coffee first. Okay, I'm ready. So how do we start?
All right, so the steps are, we're going to do a breath prayer. And you're going to breathe in, and silently in your head, you're going to say, God, you are here. And as you exhale, you're going to say, and I am with you.
So breathe in, God, you're here. Breathe out, and I am with you.
Yeah.
What's that about?
You are going to be removing the distractions. So anything that you kind of carrying, you're just going to get rid of it all and slowly become more and more aware that God's presence is actually all around you.
Okay, so it's not some kind of spell where you're summoning God, but it's more kind of becoming aware that God is already here around you.
That's right.
I guess a bit like be still and know that I am God.
Yeah.
Yes, cool. Exactly. Okay, then what?
Okay, so step two is give thanks. And this process, this bit can be a lot of fun because you're basically going to go back through your day and you're just going to be looking for kind of little things that where God was there. And could be something quite simple, could be little things, it can be big things. It's actually been likened to like rummaging through a drawer for gifts from God.
Okay.
So.
Or like when you pick up a jacket and you find a fiver in the pocket and you're like, oh, I'll just find a £5 note.
Yeah.
Okay. Because we can be forgetful sometimes of God's presence. Even if you're having a tough day, I think there's points you can find where you can be thankful to God for different things.
That's right.
Okay.
Okay. So step three is becoming aware of your emotions. And this one is kind of that examination part that we were talking about earlier. So you are going to find those points in the day where your emotions were exaggerated or out of alignment with God's heart and God's will.
So like when I flipped out at you earlier about using the pasta for lunch when I thought we might need that for dinner because we can't go shopping so much, like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Essentially.
Okay.
So, and what you're going to do is you're going to look at those emotions that you've had and maybe assess, why did I feel that way? And I think allowing God to speak into that, cause sometimes that's not always the easiest thing to know why.
Mm-hmm.
But once you do feel like you understand what's been going on inside of yourself, then you're just going to say, okay, God, I give that all back to you.
Okay, so it's thinking back to those moments during the day when you had exaggerated, your emotions became exaggerated or intense.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe bring that before God and saying, what was that about?
Yeah.
And letting God speak to you. And that might, I guess, in some ways, you might have to say sorry.
Mm-hmm.
You might have to ask God to forgive you. Or you might have some kind of hurt or something that's brought up that maybe it wasn't the emotion itself, yes, it was something behind that.
And I think the idea of this section of the Daily Examen is to become more self-aware, because when you know what's going on within you, when you know your own pitfalls, that it's you're allowing God into your heart to actually bring transformation. When you don't know what's going on, then it's very hard for God to say, like, actually, I can get in and I can do some transforming work in your life. Then you are going to take one point of your day. It could be a really sweet point, something that's just a highlight,
mm-hmm,
a really joyous part,
mm-hmm,
or it could be a really difficult part, something that's just been really burdening you, and you're going to pray into that situation. Okay. So,
okay, and then after that, then what?
And then the last part, so step five, is going to be looking forward to the next hours or to the next day with what's going to happen. So it's always trying to end that time with hopefulness, with just putting your trust in God and saying, you know, whatever comes, whatever happens, I know that you're here with me. I know that I can trust you. And so sometimes you're looking forward through your day and you're thinking, I was like, I am not really looking forward to this part. It could be something really difficult, or it could be something that you actually are really looking forward to, but both of them, it's not the circumstances so much as that
God will be with me in that.
Yep, yep. And your hope, it's about hope.
Okay.
Really.
So, become aware, be still, become aware of God's presence.
Yes.
What's the next part?
Give thanks.
Give thanks.
Yes.
For something. Become aware of your emotions.
Yes.
Choose one part, mm-hmm, of your day, one part of the day that's happened to,
yep,
bring in prayer, and then look forward with hope to, yep, the next thing.
That's it.
Okay, cool. Can we, do you want to have a wee shot at it? Kind of a compressed.
Yes.
Because I guess people can do this in a very short amount of time,
yes,
or you
can
take a chunk of time to do it. So
yeah,
we'll just do a little short one just
short
now.
One.
Maybe we can all join in.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sounds good. Okay, so we're going to start with that breath prayer. So okay. Just close your eyes, and we're just going to start. So as we breathe in, God, you are here. As you breathe out, and I am with you. Let's just do that together. Now we're going to move into giving thanks. So pick, just go through your day and find things that you're thankful for, things or areas where God was there. Now we're going to become aware of our emotions. Where did you feel your emotions very strong? And once you've named it, give it to God. Now we're going to move into praying into one aspect of our day, whether it be good or bad. We can just do that now. And lastly, we are going to move into looking forward to the next hours or to the next day with hope that God is there, God goes before you, and that you will see his presence. You'll see him move. Just we thank you that your presence is with us, and we thank you that we can look back through our day and spot those times when you were there, that we can look back and see that you weren't there just when we pray or when we're at church together, but Lord, you are with us every minute of the day. And becoming more aware of that is such a sweet and precious thing. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you for who you are. We love you, Lord. Amen.
Amen. Cool. Thank you for that. hope that's helpful. And we're going to put a little link down below to where Vineyard UK has... put some resources online that can help you with the steps, mm-hmm. remember those things, and hopefully this can be maybe a spiritual practice that you can get more used to, and I'm definitely going to tell my friend all about it. I think he'll really like it. Anyway, okay guys, have a great day. Mm. See you later.
See you guys, bye.